So good morning, everybody. My name is Corey Millar. For those of you who don't know me, I'm the team lead for the Community Strategies Hoshin. I have Albert, who's helping me here this morning, go through. So what I'd like to go through today is the A3, or the overarching A3 that we've put together for our Community Strategies Initiative. So really, this is us bringing together what we have between 11 and 14 ongoing A3s for our strategies, and this is really pulling together all of those strategies. So to give the summary of our background to the problem that we're trying to solve through our community strategies is that we have inadequate community-based services to meet the community clinical demands for our patients, clients, and residents, and the families that we serve in our community. So ultimately, what is the problem? We have an imbalance in resource alignment between community and acute care services to best serve our community. So I'm going down to the next section, section two of our A3, around current conditions. Certainly, the whole purpose of our initiatives is to deal with the overcapacity in our acute care. So our current conditions are, we have this overcapacity in acute care. And what is happening in the community is we are feeding into that overcapacity through increased transfers to acute care and to our emergency department. So admissions and ED visits through long-term care transfers, personal care home transfers, inadequate supports in our community and in agencies and areas like, I'll use for example, the Lighthouse, as well as mental health and addictions, ongoing challenges with our clients coming back to the acute care service for the supports they need due to the fact that we have inadequate allocation of resources in the community to support those clients. So going down into the goal section of our A3, and I'm obviously going through this quickly because we only have 8 minutes. Around goals, I mean, an overarching goal to the overarching A3 is all clients, 100% of our clients, so our customers should all have a community plan. All people, healthy or unhealthy, should have a community plan, which includes primary health and other supports in our community. And really, access to the ED and acute care services would either be an event that's occurred or what we would deem as a defect in our community services and not having the adequate services and supports to meet their needs in the community. So 100% of our clients should be able to access services that they need in our community setting, which would lead to the goal of zero patients in acute care requiring community services and zero long-term care clients awaiting placement in acute care. So when we get to our root cause analysis, certainly we need to do more work here in bringing together our plan and bringing together the plans from all of our A3s. So further realignment of our overarching goal to serve our community in that community settings. So I certainly see our A3 continuing to evolve, and you'll see that in future and upcoming initiatives or upcoming report outs to the community. Just slide over now to the other side. So the next section here is really around what are our recommendations, which gets into the section underneath that are around what are our initiatives. In the 14-day Hoshin, you heard us talk about the initiatives, or 14-day challenge, you heard us talk about the initiatives that came out of and have turned into projects, which we now have Gantt charts on each of them. But ultimately, we're looking to do more than that. So part of our process here is to continue to engage with the community to the organization and all the great people that are working on those projects to fulfill those projects and to continue to make them successful. But we're also going out to looking for additional initiatives as well as strategies to transform the way that we deliver care. So these recommendations really touch on that. Let me just slide down. And in the next section on the plan, that's really just a high-level summary of many of the initiatives that we spoke about in the 14-day challenge that are continuing to go forward as we implement those strategies into organizational processes and beyond. So I just want to go through some of the data that we continue to track and monitor. Let me just go on to the data section. Okay. So first our high-level value stream. So we have what our current value stream is, and we're really focusing on four areas of that value stream, which was support in the community in long-term care, personal care, mental health transition support, as well as some of our inner city supports around the lighthouse. And when we look at our PQA data in each of those areas, what we're trying to do is determine how many clients from those four segments are coming into both emergency as well as into acute care. So how many transfers in are coming into the system, and how many are staying, and how many are going back, so that we can really focus our attention on the patient flow. So we want to reduce emergency visits, but more so we want to better serve those people who are accessing services through eMERGE that then stay for an acute care inpatient episode. So that's obviously small and hard to read, but we're actually tracking and monitoring through PQA on which of these areas have the highest levels of visits, A, but B, stays. And we're certainly seeing that our transfers in from long-term care have high numbers of ED visits through transitions, but also high levels of percentages of those clients staying for an acute care visit. And this is further refining of that current state into what we want to see our future state look like with the supports in place in the community. So with that, in creating that future state and trying to better understand where to put our resources, this is just a table that talks about our data collection plan going forward. Certainly we want all of our decisions around where we're putting our resources to be driven from data that we're collecting. So this is really just our data collection plan for March and April. Just wanted to update the team as to where we are with ongoing engagement, because that's fundamental to our 90-day motion, is to continue to engage with our community and our organization and our stakeholders. So this is just an ongoing tally that we have coming out of the 14-day challenge. We've added a column for the 90-day challenge, which shows the total engagement summary. And just sharing some of the PQA data that has led into that A3, this first one being our long-term care waiting list, where those clients are and understanding where they are so that we can drill down and create strategies to create that patient flow. This is just keeping our own feet to the fire as far as where is our occupancy. So highlighting on a monthly basis where our occupancies are at each of the homes so that we can work with those homes that aren't meeting our targets. Next. This is just a summary of where we are with our personal care homes. This is obviously an area that we historically have not been really engaged with as an organization, but we see this as a huge opportunity. This is where our personal care homes deliver care to our people in our community, but you can see their occupancy is only 78%, and we're at 110, and we have people who can be served in that setting. So a big opportunity for us to engage with our community stakeholders. And just more, I'm getting the red flag here, just more PQA data here on what are our waits. So the people that are in our hospitals awaiting personal care, what are the challenges and how do we address and find solutions for them in a time.